10th standard civics 4th lesson India's foreign policy. Now we'll see in this lesson identification of the basic principles of India's foreign policy, then meaning and significance of non-alignment, different stages of foreign policy, importance of foreign policy, and difference between the domestic policy and foreign policy. We are going to see in this lesson. Foreign policy, it means government strategy in dealing with other nations. That is, government plans in dealing with other nations. The main tools of foreign policy are treaties and executive agreements, appointing ambassadors, foreign aid, international trade, and armed forces. It means why the government, in every government, even our government or any other government, why they have the policy, foreign policy. It means creating the treaties, agreement between the one country to another country, appointing ambassadors on behalf of their country or our country. We used to send ambassadors, or that people, other countries people used to send ambassadors to, on behalf of their country, sent to the other countries. Foreign aid, getting loan or anything from the other countries. International trade, even if it is export or import trade. And armed forces, dealing with military forces. This is what every country have the foreign policies. In the constitution, Article 51 said about the foreign policy, or mentioned about the foreign policy. It means promote international peace and security, maintain just honorable relations between nations, to have the relation between the nations. First one, to promote international peace and security, it means to create the peace and security between the nation. Second one, to create the relationship between the nations. Third point, foster respect for international law and international organization. It means give respect, foster respect, it means give respect for international law and organization, international organization, that is like UNO. Then fourth point, encourage settlement of international disputes by arbitration. It means to make the compromise if anything happens between the nations. That is, any problems arise between the nation. So as India has to make compromise between the nation to solve the problems. This is what in the Article 51 said in the Constitution about the foreign policy. Now, main objectives of our foreign policy: national security. Then second point, national prosperity. Third point, increasing the number of friendly nations. Fourth point, achieving world peace and enable every nation to be peaceful coexist. Fifth point, economical development. These are the five foreign principles followed by India, or are objectives of the foreign policy. Panchashil. Panchashil, it means five principles. The five principles of peaceful coexistence between our former Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru and China's Premier former premier Chow Enlai was signed on April 28, 1954. Now we'll see about what are the principles. Mutual respect for each other countries, that is between the one another, we have to be give respect. Then second one, mutual non-aggression, so we should not have the aggression. Then mutual non-interference, so mutually we should not interfere any other country's matters. Fourth point, equality and cooperation for mutual benefit. So we have to give equal to other countries, equal respect and cooperation to other countries. Fifth one, peaceful coexistence. So we have to maintain peaceful and security between the countries. These are the five principles. Foreign policy in 1950s and 1960s. With very struggle, after the long period, India got independent from the European powers. So during that time, there were two blocs, that is two groups of the countries, USA bloc and USSR bloc. So at that time, India's first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru opposed to these blocs, to these superpowers. So Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru did not want to join with the either one bloc. So he chose the path of non-alignment. It means not aligning with any bloc. He did not join with any bloc. This is called as non-alignment. Non-alignment movement, that is NAM. In 1961, the term non-alignment was coined by V. Krishnamenon in his speech at the United Nations in 1953. That is the word non-alignment created by V. Krishnamenon in the United Nations in 1953. It aimed to maintain international independence in foreign affairs by not joining any military alliance. Then the founding fathers of non-aligned movement, Jawaharlal Nehru of India, then Tito of Yugoslavia, Nasser of Egypt, Sukarno of Indonesia, and Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana were the founding members or founding fathers of non-alignment movement. Jawaharlal Nehru, Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru, India, Tito of Yugoslavia, Nasser of Egypt, Sukarno of Indonesia, Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana were the founding fathers of the non-aligned movement. India's foreign policy during Cold War era. During the Cold War, India adopted a foreign policy of not aligning itself with any major power bloc, that is USSR bloc or US bloc. So during the Cold War time, India did not join with either any bloc. It means Cold War, it means the war between the USA and USSR. But during the time, India did not join with USA or USSR. However, India closed ties with the Soviet Union and received military support from it. The end of the Cold War significantly affected India's foreign policy. This is what the situation in the Cold War time by India. New developments between 1990s and the 20th century. During the 1990s, along with the fall of the Soviet Union, global economic order, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization emerged with the support of the Western powers. India's next topic, India's policy manifested, that is India's policy showed in various ways, such as first point, better relations with China, that is the look east policy followed. Then second, nuclear test at Pokhran in Rajasthan. Next, defense procurement relationship with Israel. Next, energy diplomacy with Arab countries and Iran. Next, agreeing to US nuclear missile defense program. And finally, India's vote against Iran at the International Atomic Energy Agency. Now, in 21st century, how India developed? That is, the foremost task of India's foreign policy is to enable the domestic transformation of India. India has suggested to meet the needs of intensify economic agreement with the world, which is designed to meet the needs of an increased inflow of capital, technology, ideas and innovation for our development and our re-emergence as one of the world's leading economies. It means India wanted to develop our economical growth. So it has the contact between the other countries, like it wanted to increase the inflow of capital. Our capital, India wanted to increase our capital, technologies, ideas and innovation. So it has the contact with the other countries. Then India joined with the different groups like G20, IBSA and BRICS countries. So G20, it means group of 20 countries. Then IBSA, it means India, Brazil, South African countries. And BRICS countries, it means Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. So these are the countries India has the contact. Then India's global security concerns are reflected in its military modernization, maritime security and nuclear policies. India is facing non-military issues. So we'll see what are non-military issues. Climatical change, energy security, competition for scarce resources, food and water security, pandemics and migrations. If we have this type of the problems, but though India is concentrating to develop in the field of economic policy of disarmament. Since independence, global non-proliferation. Non-proliferation, it means to reduce the weapons, and has been dominant theme of India's nuclear policy. So India's nuclear policy is to reduce the weapons. So India supported UN disarmament program. India nuclear program in 1974 and 1998 is only done for strategic purposes. Then the two themes of India's nuclear doctrine, that is no first use. So nobody should not use armaments or weapons. Second theme, credible minimum deterrence. It means as opposed to mutually assured destructions. So no country should attack any other country or make destruction to the other country. This is what credible minimum deterrence. India decided not to use nuclear weapons for offensive purposes. It means threatening purposes. Nobody should not use, no other, no country should not use nuclear power and would never use against any non-nuclear state. No country arise up with nuclear weapons. SARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. SARC, it means South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. SARC is an economic and geopolitical organization of 8 countries that are primarily located in South Asia. So the South Asian countries are the only members in the SARC. SARC policies aim to promote welfare economics, collective self-reliance among the countries of South Asia, to accelerate socio-cultural development in the region. SARC satellite is proposed communication cum meteorology satellite by Indian Space Research Organization ISRO for the SARC region. So ISRO created the new satellite, that is SARC satellites. It is only for 8 countries. The member countries are, the 8 countries are Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal, Maldives, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. These are the 8 countries, South Asian countries, are the members in the SARC. So what is their aims? To promote the welfare economic, collective self-reliance, then the development in the field of social and cultural. Contemporary context, it means present situation about India's foreign policy. First point, prioritizing an integrated neighborhood. India gives political and diplomatic priority to her immediate neighbor, that is Maldives. So to Maldives, India gives political and diplomatic priority to the Maldives. Then India provides neighbors with support as needed in the form of resources, equipment and training. India gives more important to the neighboring countries. In what ways it is giving important to neighboring countries? To the form of resources, equipment and training. Greater connectivity and integration is provided so as to improve the free flow of goods, people, energy and capital and information. So more connectivity with other countries. Why? Because to improve the free flow of goods, people, energy, capital and formation. Then second point, bridging diplomacy and development. One of the major objectives of India's foreign policy has to be leverage. Leverage, it means has to be develop international partnership for India's domestic development. This includes improving technological access, sourcing capital, gaining market access and securing natural resources. Then third point, a gradual transition from look east to act east policy. That is, Southeast Asia begins with Northeast India. Myanmar is our land bridge to the countries of the Association of the Southeast Asian Countries. So Myanmar is in between the Southeast Asia and the Northeast India. So through the Myanmar, India have the contact with the Asian countries. The three big elements in our Eastern policy are stronger emphasis on physical connectivity, commercial
and security related. So we have three elements in our Eastern policy to strengthen the physical connectivity, commercial contact and security related. Then next topic, economic development. Many nations are moving to forge better relationship with India. It means many countries to have the relationship with, it means India, sorry, foreign countries wanted to have more relationship with India. So accelerated in what ways? It means accelerated, balanced and inclusive economic development is India's primary goal. So India's primary goal is to fast, balanced and including economic development is our primary goal to have with the contact with the other countries. Next point, fifth one, India has a leading power. India is a member of G20, that is group of 20 countries, the East Asia Summit and the BRICS coalitions, a testament to its status as a large country with fast growing economy. So because of the G20, BRICS, East Asia Summit, so through that India wanted to grow the economical condition. Difference between domestic policy and foreign policy. Domestic policy is the nation's plans for dealing issues within its own nation. Domestic policy, it means whatever issues are arising in the nations, that is inside the India, so it is solved by India. Foreign policy, same point, that is foreign policy is the nation plans for dealing with other nations. So we have the contact policy follows between India and other countries. Then second point of domestic policy, it includes law focusing on domestic affairs, social welfare, health care, education, civil rights, economic issues and social issues. These are all like domestic affairs, social welfare, health care, etc., all taken care by the Indian government. But in the same thing in the foreign policy, trade, diplomacy, sanctions, defense, intelligence and global environments, all the types of foreign policy. So these are all like trade, diplomacy, sanctions, defense, etc., all taken care by the all the countries. Finally, about this lesson is our common fight against terrorism is the main motto, main objective. Then India has sought to achieve in security and socio-economic advancement while at the same time working for peace, freedom, progress and justice to all nations and peoples. So India is working with other countries for the aim of peace, freedom, progress and justice to all nations and the peoples. Thus India follows to the foreign policy principles, that is in international relations there is no permanent friend and no permanent foe. Only the interests are permanent. It means what India is saying. So India is having the relationship with all the countries and also there is no permanent friend and also there is no permanent enemy. Only to keep the interest with the countries. This is our aim to have with the India's foreign policy.